With over 600 inches of annual snowfall, Alaska's Chugach Mountain Range is the snowiest place on Earth, which is why Kevin Quinn founded Points North Heli Adventures in Cordova. Quinn meant to build a four-star sauna and steam bath, but the helicopters cost more than he'd originally budgeted. Still, he slapped something together that works. Zach and Reggie Christ are 10-year veterans of the Chugach Mountains, but they've never skied the southwest corner of the range where Points North flies. This March, after a few of those 600 inches had already fallen, they arrived for a guided tour of Quinn's personal playground.
Big, steep couloirs here, good aspects.
But overall, we got about 1,500 square miles of terrain out here.
Possibilities are endless.
Ready to go here?
Yeah, clear on the left.
Coming
up. Seatbelts on, buckled, here we go.
Hey, wait a minute, who's this joker? You gotta get control of your people, dude.
Usually, the only guy in the helicopter who doesn't bring his skis is the pilot. Dave Barlia isn't a pilot. Well, not a helicopter pilot, anyway. Quinn calls his helicopters magic carpets, because they can take you to the top of any peak within a 1,500 square mile tenure. But getting down once you're there requires an entirely different kind of magic.
Scotty, you gotta get that guy out the door. Hey, whoa, hey, what the f***?
Barlia doesn't play on the mountains so much as he plays very near the mountains. It's enough to make the rest of the crew look nearly pedestrian. Until you realize, they're not walking down.
Day and it was over the head face shots, and now the wind's had its way with it, but what we're hoping is if the sun beating it down and the cold nights will actually break up that wing crust and make it skiable. At least that's our theory.
Quinn might be the master of this domain, but it's Mother Nature who's really in charge.
We've had wind events, we've had cold events, we've had huge snow events. Now I'm thinking that skiing is gonna be pretty damn good.
Always important to come up here with a humble attitude. And, you know, there's no limit to how big you can go, so it's really important just to kind of keep it within your realm of reality. Whatever that is.
There is no reality up here.
Flying in a helicopter in Alaska just by itself is a total adventure. You've got all kinds of eye candy just out your window. Being this close to the ocean, it just seems like it's a really active area. You know, there's a lot of life around here. It's a lesson for anyone to be able to actually come and see it with your own eyes. You can sort of see everything in its natural balance.
It takes skiers like Zach and Reggie about a day to get their bearings in mountains like this. The Chris read topographical maps like the rest of us read gossip columns, quickly and looking for the good parts.
I'm liking the looks of this one right here.
Quinn would never recommend a descent that he wouldn't do himself. Most of the time, he already has.
What people don't realize is it takes a lot of time, sometimes weeks, for conditions to become right so we can go out and maybe creep on some of these bigger slopes.
This place is known for big descents. Ideally, you get to put some ski tracks on one of those, or maybe even more than one of those.
They say the Inuit people have 2,000 words for snow, and I think we've seen like 1,500 of them in the last 2 days.
There's a scientific explanation of what causes the aurora borealis, but I prefer this Eskimo legend that explains it a lot better. As the long winter night begins to end, it's always darkest before the dawn. So if you're going to steal your neighbor's newspaper, that's the time to do it.